So, you were there at the White House last night when Margaret Thatcher was there, a guest there?
Yes, well, it was a very small dinner. Cabinet members, General Colin Powell and the Vice President, and some of the cabinet members from President Reagan's day, who were old friends of Mrs. Thatcher's, and a lot of wonderful toast. And being fortunate enough to sit next to the President, I really was very surprised and thrilled. I asked him how he was feeling. And he said that he wasn't euphoric. And I think perhaps, Hugh, because the business with Saddam Hussein isn't over. And the President said that what he really wanted to do was to get out and be with the people, that he thought that that would make him feel better. And then when I asked about the applause when he addressed the joint session of Congress, I said, wasn't that thrilling for you, all those standing ovations? And he said, yes, he said, but I know it wasn't for me. I know that it was for the armed forces.
That's a remarkable statement.
It was.
A lot of it was for him.
It was, but yeah. He was very, very modest, very relaxed, and it was quite an evening to see the two of them. It
must have been. Well, time right now for us to turn to Nightline, where Chris Wallace is sitting in for Ted Koppel. Chris?
Hugh, we'll look at two stories tonight. First, the hero's welcome for soldiers of Operation Desert Storm. Why is it so different than when troops came home from Vietnam? And the oil fires of Kuwait. How long will they burn, and what will it cost? Hugh?
We'll watch. That's 2020 for tonight. Thank you for being with us.
Remember, we're in touch, so you be in touch. I'm Barbara Walters.
And I'm Hugh Downs.
And for all of us, have a good weekend. Good night.
For a transcript of this program, please send $5 to 267 Broadway, New York, New York, 10007.
2020 is a presentation of ABC News. More Americans get their news from ABC News than from any other source.
America's watching ABC.